Hey guys, Ivan here, and today a couple of interesting things happened. So first of all, here you can see Hadi Chopin. He made his post and he says, it is written in Persian, but let me try to translate this. So he says, hey guys, I'm just joking, of course I don't speak Persian, but basically the thing that I wanted to talk about Hadi is this. So Muscle & Fitness, which is owned by American Media, which is the same organization that owns Mr. Olympia and that has revoked Sean Rotten's eligibility to compete at Mr. Olympia, posted this, so it says news, so it's breaking news. It says, Olympia working to bring Iranian bodybuilding sensation to US. Hadi Chopin, an Iranian professional bodybuilding sensation, has been called a genetic marvel, earning the praise of bodybuilding insiders and fans around the world. And so, thank God, something is happening. Something is happening and somebody is gonna try to bring Hadi to the United States and see him compete at the Mr. Olympia, which would be amazing. Now, as far as Hadi actually winning the Mr. Olympia, which is not far from possible, he is not American. So that can be a problem, that can hurt him a little. He would not be the best representation of bodybuilding because I don't know if he even speaks English. All of his posts on Instagram are written in Iranian. So if he became a Mr. Olympia, he would have to speak English and write English as well. So as a representation of the sport, he is not the best candidate. But as far as his physique, I would have no problem with him winning the show. Because when he won the Vancouver Pro, it was really awesome. I was really happy to see something like that. He doesn't even have to speak. His body spoke for itself. We saw a very high quality of bodybuilding physique that night. Something that we haven't seen in a long time. Seriously, it was really, really good. Perfect conditioning with perfect fullness, with great lines and everything. And I really loved it. It really motivated me to make more videos, to be more involved in bodybuilding. It was really sensational. It was a really good thing that happened in the sport. So if Brandon Curry or William Bonac or Rolly Winkler do not bring the perfect conditioning like Hadi brought to this Vancouver Pro, they don't deserve to beat him. Even though they are much bigger, they probably still do not deserve to beat him. Yeah, he's shorter and that can be the biggest problem for him, but he has that fullness, he has that roundness, he has the conditioning. Guys, the conditioning that Hadi can bring is another level. It is comparable with, for example, 2011, 12 or 13 version of Phil Heath. But Phil is much taller, so Hadi is not gonna look super impressive standing next to the taller guys, but the shape that he brought to the Vancouver Pro was really something impressive. Super impressive, and I'm looking forward to seeing him at the Mr. Olympia, and I hope somehow he will manage to get there. It would make bodybuilding super exciting. And American media and Mr. Olympia, actually, organizers, will not have Phil Heath most likely, will not have Kai Greenback, they will not have Sean Roden, they maybe even won't have Big Ramy. So they need to make this Mr. Olympia eventful. And what other way but bringing Hadi? Because Hadi is bringing something new, something refreshing. A breath of fresh air, for sure, for the bodybuilding. It will basically save 2019 Mr. Olympia. And yes, it does need saving. So many bodybuilders are out at this point, and we need something. We do need something to make it exciting, and I hope that's going to be Hadi Chopin. Aside from all the other bodybuilders that I already mentioned that are being out of the Mr. Olympia 2019, we're probably not gonna see Josh Lenartowicz competing there, even though he's qualified. So he made his post today and he says, hi everyone, I hope this finds you well. This is just a quick note to let you know that I'm currently dealing with a health issue that requires me to step back from social media and public interaction for a brief while. No need to panic and I'll be fine, but I need some time and space to heal and get back to full health. I'll share in greater detail down the track, but for now, just wanted to reach out and say hi and explain my recent absence. I won't be responding to comments for a while, but just know that I truly appreciate all the love, support and kindness that comes my way. See you soon and God bless. So, not very good news. He's sick. He has some health issues. Who the hell knows what it is? I guess he will update us as the time goes on, but it's not good. It's not good. Something is wrong with him, apparently, and it sucks. All we can do is hope that he gets better, that he gets well, that it is nothing serious. And it sucks that we're not going to see one of the greatest bodybuilders in the world right now at the Mr. Olympia. Another one. Too many of them are out, and this is just another one. So yeah, this sucks, but it is what it is. And as soon as he tells us what is the problem with his health, I will be the first to make a video about it, so stay tuned, guys, subscribe. And the next thing is very positive, actually. So this is about Big Ramy, and he just posted this photo right here. It's nothing special, just Big Ramy standing, and he says, "Good morning, guys." And nobody is thinking that it is anything serious. But one of my followers translated this Arabic text down below. As you can see, it's a bit longer. And it basically means the same thing, just as in English, but not exactly. He left out one very important part of it. So he says, this is something that is common in Egypt. At least that's what I've been told. So in Egypt, when they say good morning, they say something like good creamy morning. Like cream on a cup of coffee, for example. But in this case, he says good diet cream, creamy morning. So he's referring to some kind of diet cream, which implies that he's dieting right now. And the reason why he wrote it only in Arabic and not in English is maybe because he doesn't want to make it official. Maybe he just doesn't want everybody to know that he's dieting. But as I already made a video about this before, I can say the same thing again. So previously I made a video about Big Ramy commenting on his diet face. And in this new story that he posted 7 hours ago, he looks even more dialed in. His face is starting to get those wrinkles and he looks dehydrated. He looks like he's losing weight. And he's training very hard. You can see him posting videos on his stories all the time, training very hard. He's focused, he's training for something. And I think that he wants to surprise us, showing up at the Tampa Pro and winning the thing. So this would make very, very good Tampa Pro. Maybe one of the most exciting shows in this year, aside from Mr. Olympia and Arnold Classic as well, of course, and a couple of other shows that are also great. But having Dexter, having Luke now, Hassan, Charles Griffin as well, and now Big Ramy jumping in the last moment, that would be amazing. I really hope that that's gonna happen. But based on this, Big Ramy pretty much said that he's dieting. And he has a diet face. So what else do you want? I'm pretty sure he's competing this year. What about you? Whatever you think, tell me down below. And for the end of this video, you can see Justin Compton posing. Basically, he says that he's not into bodybuilding anymore. He's living an ordinary lifestyle and he's looking like this at 220, which is amazing. He's a genetic freak, obviously. I mean, he looks like this without even trying hard, which is crazy. And as a description of this video, he said something that I didn't really like. He says, "Not so throwback Thursday, hovering around 220 pounds here, just trying to provide some content for your latest YouTubers to talk about so they can make a living too. In all seriousness, this is just me living life happily and doing things I've never done in the past and enjoying myself with adventure. Food and events. Training is still per usual, but not real diet, pretty low food intake, living like a normal guy. No plans of anything whatsoever, so that should close anything anyone wants to say about it. So if you see it reposted, what's your guys' thoughts? Let me know in the comments. Politely tell them Justin says FK off." And yeah, guys like myself are making a living out of reporting on what happens in bodybuilding world, but in the process, we are actually helping the sport. And Justin is probably not aware of that. He's not aware how much media helps him out. Not just us, the guys who are making the videos, but the bodybuilders as well. And since bodybuilding is not happening on television, it is a very controversial, very dark sport, and it is not on TV, we can make videos on YouTube and make it actually alive here. But there are people who don't understand how media is important in every sport, and it's making it much more exciting and much bigger, and it makes it grow. So I don't think it's cool what Justin said here, but it is what it is. He's that kind of a person, I guess. He's probably out of bodybuilding for life. You're never gonna see him on the stage again, probably. And he had a humongous potential to become the Mr. Olympia, but he just didn't go for it, for whatever reason. Anyways, guys, enough about Justin. Tell me what you think about Big Ramy. Do you think he will compete at the Tampa Pro? Do you think that Hadi Chopin will be the Mr. Olympia? Does he really have the chances to win the throne, to win the Mr. Olympia? I think the chances are existing, for sure. But whatever you think, tell me down below and don't forget to like the video if you enjoyed it and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any future content. I'm uploading videos every single day, at least one a day. And also guys, if you want to know more about my personal life, follow me on Instagram, it's Even Bodybuilding, just like that. And I'm gonna try to be more active these days, I decided to go for it, so I'll see how it goes. Anyways, Even Bodybuilding, follow me there. All the best guys, bye bye.